one thing keeping them going.
I really have.
And for a couple of days there, a miracle seemed possible. Eerie echoes of banging noises picked up by sonar equipment lit a fuse under the search for the sub, painting a haunting picture of the five men trapped inside at the bottom of the ocean.
It just made such a beautiful media circus, you know, to talk about a race against time, these poor people, tapping sounds, ridiculous.
James Cameron wasn't surprised at all when US Navy analysis found the banging noises weren't human and were most likely from the ocean or ships in the area.
They're hearing a little crescent wrench or something tapping against a hull over the sound of 11 ships operating in the immediate vicinity, moving giant pieces of deck equipment around.
Not possible.
You know, that's like, you know, hearing a sparrow fart over the cacophony of an airport.
So that whole thing was
maybe a
fiction.
Metaphor you'll want to cut out.
That's a great metaphor.
But you're saying that.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we all got duped, I mean, and we told everybody false information. Oh, yeah. Oh, imagine that.
That they never cautioned everybody.
Coming up, the incredible rescue plans.
Once we connected to them, they were coming up.
And why the entire frenzy was pointless. Because, as you'll see, there was one critical piece of information the Coast Guard didn't share.
9:25, confirmed implosion. And I literally wrote that on the pad the moment I heard from my naval source.
So the Coast Guard lied.
The saga of the missing Titan submersible had all the makings of a Hollywood movie. Billionaire explorers missing on their way to the graveyard of a ship once thought to be unsinkable, with the clock ticking, oxygen running out, and the world watching.
I knew that this was going to be a big story.
Ed Cassano was ready to play the hero. His remotely operated deep sea vehicle, the Odysseus 6, was the only submersible that would make it nearly 4 kilometres down to the Titanic
site, and quickly.
It's just you can't make this stuff up, folks. You can't make this shit up, bro. Go check out all the videos that came out after this thing happened. All these, oh, I'm an expert. I'm a Navy expert. I can confirm this and I can confirm that and I can blah, blah, blah. And I can back up this lie story. Oh, yeah, with expert facts and blah, blah, blah. And nice little videos and everybody fucking thumbing my shit up. Millions of views. Look, this bitch got millions of views already. Just released yesterday. Ain't that something? Boy, I tell you, it's just the same pattern over and over, isn't it?
Did you at that point truly believe this was a rescue mission?
Absolutely.
4 days after...
Absolutely, he said.
After the sub disappeared and spurred on by reports of banging noises, Odysseus 6 descended through the cold, cruel depths of the North Atlantic Ocean with an incredible mission to tow the men to safety.
The plan that we had once we plugged into the scene was we would go to seafloor, we were rigged for heavy lift, we were gonna connect onto the Titan submersible. Once we connected to them, they were coming up.
It would have been a miraculous survival story, but James Cameron says it was always fiction. Tonight revealing for the first time the moment he knew the Titan had suffered a catastrophic implosion.
I just found this in my file. It says this is on Casa del Mar Stationery. That's the hotel I was in LA at the time that I heard about it. 9:25, that's AM, 9:25, confirmed implosion. And I literally wrote that on the pad the moment I heard from my naval source, very reliable source, that they had heard an event and triangulated it to the site.
That U.S.
Triangulated like a fucking narcissist. Bro, I'm telling you, dude. It's really maddening to see all this shit all the time, bro. Every time you tell people, bro, look at the fucking obvious.
Oh, you're crazy, bro. You're fucking moving. Everything's a conspiracy theory with you. Oh, yeah.
Everything sure is, isn't it? It sure seems that way. Based on observations.
Naval intelligence of an implosion near the Titanic wreck site came just hours after the Titan set off. For James Cameron, it was a deeply personal tragedy. His good friend and fellow...
And yet it still took him a year later. Oh, I guess it's the anniversary now. Is it the anniversary? The 1 year. Oh, let's trot this shit back out. Let's trot this shit back out. Let's see. When did that happen? It was about a year ago, yeah. Let's see. Banging. 11 months ago. Look at all these videos, all these views they got out of it. 15 million views on a fake story.
Oh, we're going to break it down. We're going to break down how a fucking shitty tin can didn't fucking survive to the depths of the fucking ocean. I mean, do you have to be a fucking genius? Well, yeah, you got to be a billionaire fucking, yeah, I break all the rules guy. I'm Mr. fucking, I live life by the fucking seat of my pants because I'm such a fucking smart guy. I made all this money and shit. All these experts. We're all fucking rich guys. We know better than everybody. Yeah. Yeah, we know everything. We're so smart and you're so stupid. Yeah, yeah, we all got in a fucking little tin can that couldn't make it down 40 feet. We put our billionaire ass in a little fucking rat tube. Stupid. Yeah, it was about a year ago. Oh my God, look at all these fucking views on a fake story. How much money did they make off of these fake stories? How many ads did they run on these fake stories? How many ads? Millions. Millions. And now they're trying it back out. With this, he calls himself a scientist. All right, bro.